Louis Strauss was uncharacteristically late for his appointment. And when he came, he was deeply disturbed. We did not discuss what I wanted to discuss. He told me something in great confidence. I must not mention it to anybody. And of course I didn't for many years. But of course, by now, all this is clearly in the public domain. Louis Strauss was told, he came from a discussion with the president, Eisenhower. He was told that Oppenheimer's security clearance, his access to classified material, must be investigated. And Louis was very disturbed about it. Told me he wants to prevent that. Told me that actually there have been reasons not to seek Oppenheimer's advice anymore, and nothing needs to be done about it if Oppenheimer would simply say that he is not particularly interested in continuing to give advice. I hope, said Louis, we can avoid anything worse. Oppenheimer was abroad. When he came back, the suggestion was made to him, return all classified material, don't worry any longer about atomic explosives. Otherwise, we have an order from the president to investigate your clearance. Oppenheimer decided he wanted this investigation. The reason of all this was a letter by a man called Bill Borden. He was an assistant of Senator McBain. And on the occasion, a few years earlier, when I saw McBain, he called in Bill Borden. This is my assistant, an excellent man. If you have any further questions, be in touch with him. He'll do the right thing. Bill Borden did not like the opposition to the hydrogen bomb, did not like the record of Oppenheimer, wanted Oppenheimer investigated. But his boss, McBain, and his colleagues told him, don't do anything, nonsense. A few years later, with a change in the personnel of this committee, Bill Borden stopped working in Washington, got a job with the industry, and was now free to do what he wanted. And he did, and to my mind did, unfortunately, write a letter